promise.
Well, good afternoon, everyone, and let me just thank you all for being with us. Great to have our First Lady with us today, Marty Kemp. As you all, thank you very much. As you all know, 1 year ago, a viral video shocked the world and sickened the hearts of so many in our state. Georgians and Americans in communities across the country watched in horror as the killing of Ahmaud Arbery was brought to light on our phone screens and in TV broadcasts. Ahmaud was the victim of a vigilante style of violence that has no place in our country or in our state. It quickly became clear to me and many other state leaders that we needed to act. This session, we spent time working alongside great legislators like my administrative floor leader, Bert Reeves, House and Senate leaders like Speaker Ralston, Speaker Pro Tem Jones, Dean Calvin Smyre, Representative Carl Gilliard, Chairman Chuck F. Strachan, Representative William Bodie, Representative Gloria Fraser, Representative Al Williams, Lieutenant Governor Duncan, Senators Bill Couser and Brian Strickland, as well as state and local law enforcement and civil rights leaders like Reverend Woodall and the Georgia NAACP to craft House Bill 479. This bill makes Georgia the first state in the country to appeal its citizens' arrest statute. Today, we are replacing a Civil War era law ripe for abuse with language that balances the sacred right to self-defense of a person and property with our shared responsibility to root out injustice and set our state on a better path forward. Thanks to the hard work of the people I just mentioned, our citizens' arrest overhaul received unanimous passage in the House and overwhelming support in the Senate. So often we spend time under the Gold Dome arguing over differences, but the outpouring of bipartisan support that this bill received, I believe, is a testament to the fundamental character of our state. Georgia has a long history in the fight for justice, from the civil rights movement to leading the way on criminal justice reform to passing anti-hate crimes legislation last year. Here in the Peach State, we will continue to show the world that Georgia is too great for hate. We are honored to have Ahmaud's mother, Ms. Wanda Cooper Jones, and his sister join us today. On behalf of all Georgians, I want to thank you both for being here. People all over this state and nation, the Kemp family included, have been praying for you and your loved ones this past year. I'd also like to recognize the creation of the Ahmaud Arbery Foundation, which Ms. Cooper Jones launched this past weekend on what would have been Ahmaud's 27th birthday. We all know the stroke of a pen cannot bring back what you have lost, but today, in honor of Ahmaud's memory, we commit to taking this step forward together. I want to thank you all for being here today. I again want to recognize former Representative Bert Reeves for his tireless work to get this bill across the finish line, and to the leadership of the House and the Senate and every member who supported this effort. There is no doubt that we still have challenges to face together, but we will not always agree on how to get there, but I believe that Georgia will always meet the moment and do what is right. Today, Georgia is doing what is right. God bless you all, and God continue to bless this great state of Georgia. And with that, we're going to sign this bill. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
congratulations.